Harry Reid catches
it there, and he fans back to the point. Daigneault is shot wide to the right of Froese, and now we're going to get a penalty. And I think Tockett's going to go off for interference, and here we go.
Zezel was there, and Froese took a punch at Zezel. And one thing that I understand is that Froese's temper has been getting the best of him over the last couple of games. He's been getting upset.
39 penalty minutes so far this year.
Zezel at the side of the net, and it was Froese that took the first punch.
He's just welcoming his ex.
But now it happened with the Flyers having a good opportunity. Is I think what happened, Zezel was interfering with Bob Froese. He was hooking his leg, and then Froese took a punch at him, and they both went after each other. But it was Zezel who was pulling Bob Froese's leg to begin with. That's why Froese took a punch at him, and I think that's what was going to be called initially by Don Koharski, because soon as grew up in Lansdale, and he's a big kid. And
he went right after Brown, and just actually went right after looking for it.
Yeah, and it happened when Brown and he were just jostling in front of the net. And I think everybody is waiting, at least on the Rangers side, to see how this big kid can do. George McPhee calls him the eighth continent in the world because he's so big. But he and Brown went off, and it doesn't seem like there's that many punches thrown.
But Brown, and I guess Cochner again, and they go down heavily in that corner. Caulfield make that. Oh, Brown burying him. Oh! Mr. Caulfield, you are the first National Hockey Leaguer from the Philadelphia area to play in a game at the Spectrum, and you did that Thursday, but you're getting hammered, my friend, right now. As Dave Brown, for the second time in the game, he and Caulfield went at it. They each got five for fighting at 10:40 of the second period. Caulfield also got an instigation call. Two heavyweights. One might have to give the decision there to Dave Brown.
They start to go. Berube has Frawley down. Berube's on top of him. That started right from the faceoff. Well, Berube has come out, taking a minor penalty, and then decided he wanted to fight.
I guess this is what Berube thinks he's paid to do. I mean, when you think that that's what you're supposed to do, you just go out and do it. I mean,
and then Sandstrom mugged. It looked like Howe, and then Howe got his stick up on Sandstrom, was then cross-checked, and oh, yeah, Brown really gave it to him in the chops. But after the shot, Sandstrom was worked on by Howe, and then mugged Howe, and then Howe came up on the fall and got Sandstrom across. Then McCrimmon came in and drilled Sandstrom, and then Brown gave it to him. Traded along with Jerry Bopp. Now we got one, Williams and the Mellenby. And Williams, who's supposed to be so big and mad, no longer drops a stick or his glove. And they'll both go off, but Mellenby will have to be certainly the heavier penalized, because he really took two shots, knocked Williams down, and played. Now there's a bust into the zone. Carson on the backhander, and it rolled off the stick.
Oh, what a hit.
And then he's really hit by Ledyard.
Behind the play.
Yeah, what do we got?
The three and knockbar.
That's the one thing about those in-close battles. That helmet can really play havoc with your knuckles. And Knockbaugh was able to knock the helmet off of Basil McRae and is throwing some overhand rights at McRae. But I don't think you're getting very...
Oh, they're really in close. They're not getting much on it.
No.
Both players just grappling here now. And the Lions are quick to jump in between, or trying to jump in between the two combatants. Knockbauer still got that one arm free.
He switched hands on him.
All right, while they cool. Oh, here we go. They didn't cool. And Tockett and Moeller.
They're not, I think you'll see much more of a wrestling match if they can get loose. Not too many punches has been thrown. Oh, Tockett landed a couple left. It glanced off the chin of Moeller.
I think Moeller's just more of a clutch and grabber rather than throwing the hands, although he's attempting to get the right hand loose.
He's a big fella too. And they're both down on the ice.
That takes up so much energy when you're pushing and shoving like that as hard as you can.
It's Huff and
Tockett, I believe. No, it's Mellenby. Two youngsters. Boy, they're really going at it there. They're trying to get loose to get some punches in. And Mellenby's knocked the helmet off of Huff. And now he's got him on there, knocking him down, and now he's on top of him, and now the linesmen have the chore of trying to separate the two.
Couple of big, tough boys. And here we go. Heavyweight City.
Wow.
Somewhere, but
I think that first exchange for Ruby caught him.
Yeah. Boy, I'll tell you, that was a battle that we've not seen the end of. So have a go at me. And just let me get this right hand loose. Boy, are they feeling each other out. Look out. Boom, boom. Of course, with that right hand loose.
Boy, he just keeps,
you know, Grubin. Joey's got a hold of that sweater. That's the key to that fighting, boy. He's got a hold of Berube's sweater in the right arm, and he really can't get it loose right now. Kosar, of course, he and Berube now has got his right arm, and that's the key. A couple of big, strong guys, and they both know how to handle themselves with the other hand other than the punching hand.
Are breaking 2-on-1. Up ice on the near side. Knock Bowers hit in the face.
An elbow.
Yeah, and we get a stoppage of play. And Knockbauer is going to go right after Warren Young.
He should. It looked like he was going to get a penalty on that, but no call was made. Now Young is really a Knockbauer trading punches. And we have a good one going right now. LaToya, Young. Oh, Knockbauer landed some three or four real good rights, and now Young's trying to hang on. But the thing is, it started with Young throwing that blatant elbow. Now we have Hospodar down in front of the goal with Mitch Wilson. So we have two guys or four players going after it. Oh, there's a butt right there by Mitch Wilson. Whether Hogarth will call it or not, he didn't call the elbow, but he sure has his hands full here as we have two fights out on the ice.
And Probert, and now Berube is in there, and here they go. They had a big one in Philadelphia on Saturday, won by Berube.
Hey, Probert hit the goaltender, Hextall, and then went after Daniel, and then now Berube's coming in. Now Probert is getting that right hand up underneath Berube, but boy, did they have a heavyweight battle in Detroit, or probably in Philadelphia on Saturday afternoon. Neither one of them now can get loose. And they are holding on to each other, and they're punching hand pretty good. Club went at it. Then this is when Stefan came in and went after Daryl Stanley out of the crease. Stefan cross-checked him to the ice.
Automatic. Not even a question. Automatic. Third man in an altercation. There.
Kosar wanted to get in on it. He missed a lot of it, so he had to get into something. And he and Brian Dobbin's first regular shift of the game, had a good scoring opportunity. Now Kosar is trying, and he is landing some real strong right hands on young Brian Dobbin.
Right in front, shot, what a save, and boy, somebody is hurt in front as he was checked and fell back on his back and hit his head hard. And I'll tell you, Bobby, without a helmet, that could have been very serious.
As Lindsay is stretched right out there, Nord comes in and gets him with a solid shoulder. The shoulder hit him on. And they now, oh boy, Stevens got a couple of good uppercuts in there, and Stanley is still trying to get him loose, and now he's throwing with the left hand, and they're both landing some good shots. We have another heavyweight bout, Gene. We've seen them over the last couple of games, Berube and Bobby Probert with Detroit. Now Stevens and Daryl Stanley here tonight.
With a shot, Hextall grabs that one and hangs on. With 3:08 left in the third period, 8-5 Islanders.
Here we go. We got Berube and Curran going at it here. Two heavyweights. Curran went right in there. Berube was standing right there, and they just looked for each other. And down with the sticks and the gloves. The linesmen are quick to jump in now as both players have fallen to the ice. But that all happened after we had kind of a skirmish in front of the net.
Still have that second shot to win a game on the road tonight in the foreign building.
Well, he got Brown in the key. Oh, Brown is landing some shots on Nick Dean. He is really landing him.
Third man in,
third man
Rangers.
In was the Ranger defenseman, Grant Brown. But oh my goodness, did Brown tee off of George McPhee? There's a big difference in height, but the Rangers.
Well, that was right off the faceoff. It just jabbed at one another.
Yeah. And now the linesman has a hold of the Flyer and not a hold of the Ranger. Now he's trying to hold him up. Fouls, and that is all heart. Have been blown at one another, and you just hardly wait to break it loose.
To go back to Poulin, who was in front of the net, the Rangers broke it up, and now we got another penalty. Let's see against who. Was it Froese or was it Poulin? Attack with Froese, and as Poulin came the other way, he got him right up on the choppers.
Scored. And now we have a fight with Price and Carson.
And
wait a minute, no, that's
Craven.
That's Craven.
And he's and Kaharski's telling everybody else to get away. Not Bauer and Basson.
That's exactly who it is. And Knockbauer's a lot bigger than Bob Basson, but Basson has been able to hold him off until the last couple of punches, but Knockbauer landed him.
You could almost sense something was happening. Knockbauer, first of all, had a staring contest with Billy Smith.
Dropped up. Bob Fontaine is bumped. Samuelson trying to come out, and after all of that rugby scrum, we get a stop at the play.
Three power plays, but Pat LaFontaine then came back at when Mellenby took a punch at him, but LaFontaine threw the elbow first and was pushing and shoving and punching along the boards. He failed to show that.
Down at center ice with Alan Kerr, and Kerr's getting pounded, and I don't know what started that at all, although Kerr had it earlier in the period with Philadelphia's Shel Samuelson. Right side puck, and he looked, drive high off Hextall's shoulder, and he covers the puck to the right of the goal. And then Basson is in there, takes a poke, and here we go. Basson and Rick Tocchet, and this is all unnecessary. And then people in the corner are throwing stuff over the glass. Tocchet is working on Basson, and finally separated by.
Well, here we go, right in behind the net here now. Corson and that's Tocchet and Corson. They just had enough talking, I guess, and decided to get something done about it. Brought off their gloves.
Berube is being separated from Lemieux now by the referee, Morel.
Lemieux won't want to have any part of Berube. But this is the first one we've seen. Now you have two big...
We got a
Stanley.
Stanley and who?
And Nyland. And... Stanley's landed a couple of punches, and Nyland's just trying to hold on. But Stanley got the best on him. Now, they're really trying to loose up. Ooh, he got a good uppercut. He got a good punch on the eye, and now he's really giving it to Stanley. So Nyland waiting
here with Mike Stuthers.
They started, Nyland dropped the gloves first. He's getting much more punches in. Stuthers trying to protect himself so he can get some leverage, but he hasn't been able to do that as Nyland got the best punches in. But Gainey was the player who knocked down